beast in the jungle, in the heat of the rumble. I ain't got nothing to lose. Hey, I've been fighting these hard times in the ghettos of my mind. That was victory that I choose. Hey, bless my soul, is blessed the king is born. Mama, I confess I'm a bad, bad man. Ain't no one like me.
I'm Larry Ridley, and you're tuned in to Madden 18 on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today. There's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's Roethlisberger Steelers going up against Foles Eagles.
Okay, Larry, thank you. We are just off I-95 at the home of the Eagles, Lincoln Financial Field, on the south side of Philadelphia. Just a short time ago, these Philly fans in full roar as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. Pyrotechnics ablaze. They're set to go as their Eagles will match up. With Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. To about the 29, just shy of the 30. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. To throw here, Roethlisberger. It's caught by Bryant. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. Out left side here to Bryant. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to grade the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Now Roethlisberger on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, They're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Shipped together here from the D-line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only the control and things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield, to get to what we call the second and the third levels, you know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. Play clock winding down. Now Roethlisberger. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. So the football switching hands here in just a second. And, you know, Tom Brady, just to go off on a tangent for a second, may have lost the Super Bowl, but third MVP this past season, and what he did at age 40, really something, right, Charles?
Absolutely phenomenal. Ended up beating out Todd Gurley, the running back for the Los Angeles Rams. But he would have traded it for a Super Bowl win, don't you think? How about this? The last nine NFL MVPs to play in the Super Bowl that same season, 0-9.
Yeah.
He had gone all the way back to Kurt Warner in, what, 1999, where he won the double?
We were going over that stat earlier. That is hard to believe.
But he would have been the MVP had the Patriots pulled that one out.
Yeah, he still has five rings, though, five Super Bowl titles for Brady. Now Wentz on third down. The connection here with Nelson Agholor. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. So those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Going up top. It's caught at the 10. And he takes it down deep into Pittsburgh territory. It's a big play there for the Eagles. 43 yards. And now the offense operates in the red zone. Now a first carry for LeGarrette Blount. And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Wentz to throw on second down. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. A great effort there. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. He's got it, and the Eagles lead at 7-0. Now to kick this one away. I want to give a hat tip real quick, Charles, to J.J. Watt before the possession switches here. Walter Payton, NFL Man of the Year. They totaled up how much he helped raise for hurricane relief, $37 million.
$1,000. So congratulations to J.J. Watt and all the people who participated. And Greg Olsen of the Panthers, Benjamin Watson of the Ravens, both tight ends, also nominated and finalists for the most prestigious award as determined by the NFL, the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award.
23 yards on the play. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. Man open left side is Brown. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down. But no matter your experience level as a quarterback, you throw an interception on that first drive, maybe a little shaken up. Nice response there to get their first down.
I think you make an excellent point. I don't care who you are. You throw an interception, it's going to get to you a little bit. But the ones that we've seen that are the best, you never notice it. They don't come to the bench, throw their helmets, they don't do any of that. They just go back out the next drive and act like it never happened.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Now Roethlisberger. This one complete, right side to McDonald. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
From the red zone now, here's Roethlisberger on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Bryant. That throw good for four. It's second down. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4 for 4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row. I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
Here's Roethlisberger. Just a yard or two shy of midfield. Eagles will take over here in just a second on offense. And Charles, as you look back to the Super Bowl title run that they just had, what were some of the moves that made that possible?
I'll keep it on the offensive side of the ball because I thought their front office did a fantastic job of having answers in case things happen. Carson Wentz goes out. Well, they had signed Nick Foles to back him up. That worked out pretty well. Getting Alshon Jeffrey as a weapon outside to help.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off. It's the Pro Bowl corner. Joe Hayden with it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And the Steelers set to take the field. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Roethlisberger will throw. Throw left side complete. That's Bryant. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Roethlisberger now to throw on third down. Hard throw, incomplete.
On third and one, I think everyone in the stadium thought they'd try and run the football there, but they tried to surprise the defense and hit something through the air. Instead, it results in an incompletion.
And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. They'll indeed go for it with Roethlisberger. So they take over not only in enemy territory, but in the red zone at the 16-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turned to block, find the spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down.
So when the defense complains about having to do pursuit drills in the heat of training camp, plug in this play. Excellent pursuit. Force the quarterback out of the pocket. He ends up trying to run for it. Instead, he goes out of bounds and loses yardage. That goes down as a sack for the defense.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. Boy, stays up. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. That one good for 10 yards. And that is going to set up a third and one. Wentz going to give this one to Blunt. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead him to fourth down.
On every snap, a defense is trying to establish who they are. But on third and short, that's really when you put it out there and tell people who you are. And that's exactly what they did. For the offense, they're looking at their offensive line and saying, guys, where are you? We need you on those plays.
Remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. This is a Jay, and he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. Give him right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. Now a toss play. It's Ajayi. And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Jay Ajayi punching it in from a yard away. And the Eagles had six to their lead. And it's good to make it 14-0. Now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now out come the Steelers. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. And the slot man goes in motion left. Second and 10, it's Roethlisberger once more. A screen to Bell. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13. First down now, but the clock continues to move. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Now it's Roethlisberger. Over the middle, hauled in by Smith-Schuster. And he is going to feel that one. Knocked down hard at the 47-yard line.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Now the offense lining up first and 10. Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly to sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. He's going to sling this deep downfield, and it's caught. It's Brown. Touchdown, Steelers. Antonio Brown, as the first half is winding down, and the Steelers are able to make this a close game again. And he puts it through. Boswell on now to kick this one away. On the return, it's Kenyon Barner. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
We'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Here on first down. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to the other side of the field. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. And they're going to go soft on the corners. They'll run it now out of the gun. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That's it for the first half. Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this. looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you're all looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Arthur Motes. From that outside linebacker spot, he's able to get in there for a loss of 9. Eagles coming up here on a 3rd and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. Working from the gun, Wentz. And Jeffrey's got it. And they pick up 25 as they convert on 3rd. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And this is going to be intercepted. Trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard, because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
A very solid gain of 27. You know, when I see passes like that, I'm reminded of something you and I talked about yesterday. Big Ben was a wide receiver the first 3 years of high school, sitting behind the coach's son, and then he finally got that opportunity. I think he's made the most of it.
It's always the coach's son, isn't it? But you know where it helps him? When he looks downfield, he knows what the receivers are going to do. He actually has wide receiver's eyes when he's throwing the ball.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. They'll go again with Bell. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall near the 42. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
It's funny, partner. Le'Veon Bell, when he came out of Michigan State, when I go back and look at my analysis of him and what my grades were for him, thought he was a big-time player, great potential, but I didn't know we were going to get this player. I was used to a big, solid, thick running back, but now I've got a full package, a guy who can do everything, as we just saw there, including breaking tackles.
But at the time, 2nd-round pick in 2013, some people probably wishing they'd taken him in the first. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
Now they'll throw it with Roethlisberger. His throw incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Now Roethlisberger to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off near the 32. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
All right, Brandon. Normally when you hear about guys making two interceptions in the game, you're thinking, must be a free safety, maybe a corner. How about getting two picks out of one of your linebackers? Again, he's just in the right place at the right time. That's another great play to come away with the football.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. That ball's caught. Aguilar, right side. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or a man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. He's going to let this one go deep. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
Back to the air on second down. Wentz. Being chased out left. It's caught inside the 25. And he takes it down deep into Pittsburgh territory. A gain of 39 that time.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
And they'll go Wentz to Blunt here. And he'll get about three just outside the 10, stopped at the 11.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
The Eagles on third down. They've been near perfect, 4 for 5 to this point. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Here's Wentz to throw. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Zach Ertz, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Eagles add on to their lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field.
And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now Roethlisberger. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 45. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Now a play fake here on first down. Caught right side is Jeffrey. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Fresh set of downs here. Anyone?
Now a play fake. Wentz. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And down inside the 15 he goes. 15 yards through the air and a first down. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
Now it's a Giant. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Wentz to throw on second down. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that line?
And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off down near the 5. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. Is the play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. After the interception, here's Roethlisberger. Eluding the pressure right. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Fletcher Cox. Able to get in there and drop him behind the line. And now the offense will look to respond after the sack. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. And McDonald here over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. He got 29 yards that time. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off near the 32, and this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. And that gives him now 3 interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get 3 in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against with the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
It's caught by Aguilar. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It's a gain of 13 for number 13, and it gives him a first down. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. So the offense has it first and 10. They fake the give. Now Wentz. It's going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Wentz to throw. And he's going to go out of bounds. He takes this one down shy of the 20. 23 yards on the play. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long.
And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Alshon Jeffrey from 21 yards away. And the Eagles had 6 to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Now the Steelers offense gets ready to get back onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue.
And now here is another interception. Picked off by Ronald Darby, and he takes this one back